Hello developer, welcome back to this channel. In this video we are going to talk about Blazor server and authentication using individual account. Now before we dive into this, I want us to understand what authentication is and how to apply authentication in Blazor server app. From this link, we have a definition for authentication and authorization, but we want to focus on authentication first. If you read here, now it is saying authentication and authorization are two aspects of security that are very important in an application. Both are different, but go hand in hand. Now let's focus on authentication. Authentication is a process of verifying the identity of a user, whether or not he is allowed to use the application. When you create your application, the first thing that you want to do is to set up an authentication system. Now this system allows the user to use the application, or it can prevent the user from using your application. It's like a door whereby you open the door to the room. Now if you decide to close the door or lock the door, no one can get into the room. If you decide to open it, everyone can have access to the room. That is what you'd call as authentication. Users who are not verified are still sometimes allowed to use application on a limited basis. So maybe you would like to set up an area or a free space for those who are not authenticated. So if you're authenticated or not, you can still use. But when you are authenticated, or when you are part of the application, part of the system, you can have more features than you're not. Now, it is also saying that authentication can be done in various ways. The most common for application is checking the username and password. That is what we use. Username and password. It could be email and password, a PIN code and a password, staff ID and a password. Okay, so it depends on the authentication system that you want to use, but the common one that we all know is username and password. Another example is the use of the fingerprint on the smartphones, or PIN code when using a debit card at the ATM. Okay, so you can see that you just slot your card, you pass in your PIN code, it gets authenticated. If you forget your PIN code, you can see you can't have access to the system. That is what you know as authentication. When the user first opens a website that requires authentication, he will register on that website. So the first thing to get the authentication system here is, first, you have to register first. So that's why when you go to applications, you have to create an account. After creating an account, all relevant information such as usernames, a password, email, etc. will be stored in the website database. When user enter their names and password, the data will be checked database. If the data match the database, then he is valid and authenticated user. So that is how it goes. If you pass in your credentials, username and password, you check what you have registered already. If they correspond, then you are not authenticated. So I believe by now you've gotten the idea of authentication. If the user enter a name or password that does not match the database, the login page will respond, for example, giving a message, invalid login attempt. Okay, so that is it for authentication. Now, authorization is also a different thing together, but for now, we want to focus on authentication. So how do you perform authentication in Blazor server app? I've done a video on the authentication in Blazor WebAssembly. I'll leave the link and a bit description so you can just watch that if you want to practice on that. But this time around, I've also done a video theory on how to set up from initial stage to the final stage. How do you perform authentication? But what you're going to do here is very simple. You're going to use a built-in system that is known as individual account. Now this individual account is a built-in system that has everything that you have to use to be able to authenticate as or register and log into the system. So all that you have to do here is just select the authentication system, then we just keep going. So let's start with a practical for you to understand this. Now, when we are done, we must able to have something like this. I created an application over here, like a Blazor application over here, and I have these buttons are the default buttons. Now, when you check on top here, we see I have a login and register, right? So login and register. Now, as soon as I click on login, it gives me the interface for login. Now register, it gives me the interface for registration. So let's register and see. So I'm going to pass in admin@admin.com. Password is admin@123. So admin@123. Now let's register and see. So they do not match. admin@123. Okay, so admin@123. All right, now let's see. So this is going to register us. Okay, now let's see. So let's confirm. So click to confirm. Now thank you for confirm your email address. Now you can now log in. So when you start to pass in admin, the password is admin@123. You can now log in. So we see, as soon as you click on that, I'm able to log in over here. So as you can see, hello admin@admin.com. So that is what we call as authentication system. So how do you create your sign up login registration form? How do you create your login form? How do you authenticate the user, check the database and confirm if the data that the user performed correspond to what we have already? Okay, so that's what known as authentication. So let's get going. First of all, what you have to do here is you have to create a new application, that's a Blazor server app. Now in that, just click on file, then so that is launch your Visual Studio 2022 or any version that you have. My prefer 2022 because that is what I'm going to use for the .NET framework 7.0. so let's wait for it to respond. Then we're going to create a new project. So file, let's see, let's wait. All right, so file, new, then new project. Now with this project, you wait for the template to get loaded, then we choose Blazor server app. Now it is not Blazor WebAssembly. I've done a video on this Blazor WebAssembly and I'll link it under the description. So if you want to know how to do that, you can just go there and I'll find out how to do this Blazor WebAssembly authentication. But for now, let's choose the Blazor server app, click on next. And now in here, the name here is, so let's use Blazor server authentication. Now choose the location and click on next. Now in here, that is where we have to make some change over there. The next thing here is when loading the template or additional information, the framework that you are using here, it is 7.0. The authentication type that you want to use is known as the individual account. So click on this and now let's click on create to get it created. So the type that we're using here is an individual account. As soon as you select an individual account, now the whole thing gets created. And it's an inbuilt system that has the login, the registration, and all other the JW2 services and everything as well to enable us to get account created and also to log in as well. So that's all we need to do to get application being authenticated. So let's wait while it is creating the application. So we wait. All right, so as you can see, now it is almost ready. Okay, so yeah, start recording. All right, so our application is now ready. You can see we have a new project and that the name is Blazor server authentication. Now when you go to solution explorer, we have the project source. So we have over here, as you can see, Okay, so that is it. Now you can see we have an area, we have our data. Now when you open data, you can see we have application DB. We have our migration performed. When you go to the pages, let's see what we have in the pages. So we have the normal ones over here. Okay, now when you go to program.cs file, let's see what happened. Now as soon as you select into the account, it adds this folder known as the area. Okay, that is where we can find the login password for assisting us to log in. So let's wait for the program.cs file to get loaded. Then we see. Okay, so as you can see from here, we have our connection string registered. We have our database connection being registered over here. Aside from that, we see we have the default identity also registered over here. Then we have, that is the dependency injection. So we are using authentication state provider. Then you want to get an instance of this. That's a revalidating identity authentication state provider. Okay, so this is the dependency injection that we are calling over here. Now the next thing that we have to do here is, it was done defaultly by using dot authorization. So this is also the default one using the middleware pipeline. So registering this authorization. So this means that applications should use an authorization system to control how user gets into the application and gets out as well. Okay, so now we have this. All that we need here is to let's run. So click on this button to run this application and let's see the output of this. So you can see we've done nothing, just have to click create the application. Now click on the run button to run it. So let's wait what it gets built, run, and see the output of that. All right, so application is now ready. As you can see from here, that's a Blazor server authentication. Now we have our buttons right here, register and login. Okay, so we have these buttons defaultly. Now when I click on login, what do you have now? Let's wait for the login to pop up. Okay, now you're not having any account over here, so let's register first. So let's pass in an email. So let's use this admin, or let's use this. So maybe, yeah, we can maintain the admin, of course. So let's maintain that, and now let's set a password at the same admin at 123. Now admin at 123. Let's create an account right there. So we wait for the account to get created. Alright, so we see here it is saying that database operation failed while processing the request. So this means that we haven't performed migration. So let's apply migration. Now it is done. So let's refresh this application, continue. Now we are registering. Let's confirm our email. Now let's log in. So we pass in this admin and 123, that's a password. So you can see now we are also logged in. So hello admin, we have logout. Okay, if we right click on this and go to inspect element, now let's see, this is going to generate a token that's going to be used as the HTTP request header. So when you go to the network tab, let's click on this fetch data. We're going to have the controller popped up. So let's see what we're going to have over here. So Blazor server authentication state. Now that's the header over here. So if we check the header, let's see if we can have, so do we have any response? Let's refresh this again and see what we have now. So as I click on, so we can now click on logout to log it out. And we're gonna have login. So now login, we can now provide our credentials again. And now a login. Okay, so you can see this is very simple. So that's the simplest way of using authentication in Blazor server app. Now I can do the same thing to the Blazor WebAssembly. The same process, you can just have the same process through the same steps, and you're gonna have the Blazor server at Blazor WebAssembly app also. Been authenticated by using the individual account. So So I believe this is simple. And next video, we're going to talk about how do you assign role or how to perform a role-based authentication. As soon as the user logs in or registers or and logs in to the account, what are the features that you want the user to have access to? And what are the others that you want to prevent from the user? That is what you know as authorization. We're going to talk about that in the next video. So I believe this is clear. Thank you guys for watching, and don't forget to subscribe as well, like and share in case you're interested in what I'm doing here. So thank you, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.